So welcome students, now we come to the application of all the momentum flux that we learned in earlier videos. We will apply those concepts to real life problems. For example, the first problem I have taken here is flow of a falling film, and you will find this study or discussion in your transport phenomena book, chapter number 2, first section. What is this flow of a falling film? It is actually like this, that you can imagine. Suppose so here what you see here is a plate, metal plate, and it is inclined to the horizontal at some, maybe some, there may be some angle. So what you do here is that you start pouring, for example, water, or you start pouring something like paint here, so that all this this edge is gets in a uniform way. So what will happen, that this paint will start flowing and it will fall here same way. This kind of flow you will, you can imagine over the plate, and this kind of thing you can imagine it happens on the rooftop when there is rain, water falls, then it flows over that rooftop or plate. So this kind of system we will study here. And what we will study here, that suppose this is a paint, so what thickness of that paint will come, means it will happen naturally, some thickness will be there. So we will have to develop a formula what thickness of this paint will be on the surface, and what will be the velocity of this film at this surface, because velocity will be different to that height. At the plate it will be zero, and then it will start increasing. So what is the average velocity of this film, and then how much paint will flow per second through this area, that or you can say volumetric flow rate, what will be there, and what will be the mass flow rate. So all these things we need to calculate here, or you can say that we will develop mathematical formula for that, and you will see some good application of the momentum flux concept in this section that we are going to discuss. Here you can see the, I have represented here the schematic diagram of that film, and the film will not be this much thick, but for the sake of clarity I have taken this much thickness of the film, and very clear cut boundaries I have taken, so that it can be represented mathematically. First step is that what you will do is that you will choose a coordinate system. So already I told you, you will take you will use right hand rule for taking the coordinate system, and if you will take that, you will find that you can take it like this, this x axis and this y axis and this z axis. Choosing the coordinate directions, orientation depends upon the system, whatever is suitable to you. So I have taken this way, and after then the step will be to choose a very small thickness shell. How you will choose that? It will depend upon the orientation of the system, and there can be many ways, but some suitable shell is chosen for the system. For example, here you can see that the shell has been taken, this shell has been taken, this you can see this, it will be a kind of rectangular block, and you have taken its thickness from x is equal to here some value will be there, and x is equal to x plus delta x. X plus delta x, or you can say the thickness of this cell is delta x, and the width of the plate is w, and the length of the plate is l. This is your plate. So now what we will do, that we will see in what ways the momentum flux can enter into this cell, and we will decide have to decide what direction of the flux will be there. I told you that there are three directions of flux can be, because it will have it can have all three directions. So you will have to decide here in what direction the momentum flux is entering into this cell here. So you can see that the film is flowing in z direction, so it will definitely have vz velocity, and there is no movement in this direction, so vy velocity will not be there, and also it is not moving downward like this. There is no downward flow, because it is flowing parallel to the plate, so there will not be any vx velocity. So you can say that there will be only one component of velocity, that is vz, and momentum flux is decided by this velocity, because momentum is nothing but mass into velocity. So there will be only z component of the momentum flux. So we will here analyze the z momentum flux. So this is the kind of steps in this cell analysis, that first you will decide the coordinate system, after then you will decide what kind of cell you have to choose, and after then you will decide what direction of momentum flux in that cell will be, and after that, when we have analyzed the system that there will be only z momentum flux, then we can see in what way this z momentum flux will be entering into the system. And already we know that there are these six phases are there. So through this phase this momentum flux can enter, and you already know that suppose this is your z phase perpendicular to z axis, so this will be z phase, and this big surface area phase, it will be your x phase, because it is perpendicular to x, and what is y phase, it is this is your y phase. So there will be two y phases, two x phases, and two z phases, and through these phases the flux will be entering. So okay, let's first take this x phase, that it will be over here and down at the bottom. So I have drawn this thing, means you are watching this in this way, towards this way, so you will get this kind of scene here. We have this is our cell of thickness delta x, and this point will be, suppose this is x, and this will be x plus delta x, and we are interested in this phase x, and this phase. So now I will discuss here the velocity. This film is flowing in this direction, so if you will concentrate your attention here the velocity will be zero, because molecules will be stuck to the plate. This is your plate, and after then when you come upward, little upward, then you will see that molecules will be moving with some velocity, and after then the more you will come up, you will see more and more velocity you will see here, and then inside this cell you will find this velocity and more velocity at this surface, and up here you will see that much more velocity here. So now suppose you concentrate your attention here on this means on this whole surface, this the surface, upper surface of the shell. Here you see that at this point the molecules are having this much velocity, and inside this cells molecules are having only this much velocity. So these molecules have more momentum, so they will transfer their momentum to this by viscous stress. Means they will like to take these molecules with them, and these molecules will get their momentum. So this way momentum transfer will be there, and this is because of the viscous action. So we can say that here this element that is of the lesser x, and this element that is inside the cell, it is of greater x. This element will put a stress in this direction, and what it will be represented by tau. And now the element of lesser x, onto the element of greater x will put a stress in the z direction. Already I explained you very much, and I gave it much more importance to understand. This stress will act here, and the direction will be this, and this is on the cell. And now the another thing is this, here also you see that velocity difference. Now the molecules are inside the cell, they are having more velocity, and the molecules that are outside the cell, just adjacent to it, they are having less velocity. So these molecules will try to give their momentum to these molecules. So again they will put kind of stress in this direction on this this element, and because of the action reaction rule, this element will put stress in this direction. So the cell, this is our center of attention, our cell will feel stress in negative z direction, that is the important point, and that will be minus tau x z. Same kind of notation will be there. So now one more point, that because these two notations seem the same, so to differentiate it we can put here this way, this represents the surface, this surface. So when you that vertical bar, and with x it says that this is the shear stress at this x surface, and here we put here x plus delta z. It says that it is the stress on this surface, it is the x plus delta z x surface. So you will see in book this kind of notation. So this way on x surface this momentum flux will enter. So we have analyzed the viscous stress, and I told you that there is also pressure kind of momentum flux also, and bulk flow kind of momentum flux also, and here we are discussing z direction of the momentum flux. I already told you why. So it is natural that it will act on the cell, but will the pressure act in the z direction here? Pressure will act in the z direction? No, because pressure is always acting in the perpendicular way, and we are discussing about z direction. So pressure effect will be zero, and same way here also pressure will be zero, so it will not be taken into consideration. Now because of the bulk flow we are dealing with here the surface x, so here it should come here x vx, because it represents the mass flux, and here this will come vz. So we can see that vx velocity is not there, because there is no velocity towards this way, there is no velocity, it is zero, so it will not be there. Or you can imagine that no molecule is entering this way, vertically no molecule is entering. So on the x face there will be only stress kind of viscous kind of momentum flux. So I end this lecture here. Next lecture I will discuss about other faces. We will take y face and z face. We will see that what kind of flux is there.